Hey there! In this lesson, we will make a bulletin board of your favorite hopscotch projects using the open project block. You will get to decorate your board at the end and unleash your inner curatorial skills. Let's get started! Step 1. Adding sticky notes. Let's start by making the contents of our bulletin board. I will first make a title for my board by adding a text object. Open the Objects menu by tapping on the gray and white plus button at the bottom half of the screen. Then, tap on the button with two emojis on it to create a text object. I will call it my favorite hopscotch project this week and drag it to the middle of the stage. You can check the position of the title by pressing the play button to see how it looks like on your screen, and then press the back arrow to go back and adjust the position of the title. The next thing we need on our bulletin board is the sticky notes that tell people which projects we like. To make a sticky note, open the Objects menu by tapping on the gray and white plus button again, and this time we will scroll right to the Shape section and add a square. Use two fingers to pinch the square to adjust the size of the sticky note. Then tap on Add Code and find the When Game Starts block. Next, scroll to the Looks and Sounds section to find the Set Color block. You can choose any color you like for your sticky note. Then tapping the empty space below this pink container, we will add a When Is Tapped block. Tap on this text field to change it to When Self Is Tapped. Scroll right to the Control Flow section and add the Open Project block. This will make sure that when someone taps on the sticky note, a project will be opened. You will need to copy and paste the project's URL link to this block to open the project. Step 2. Copy and paste project URLs. I will show you how to copy the link of any project in Hopscotch.
Watch the entire section on how to copy the project URL. Then you can follow the steps to copy the project of your choice. Once you exit this project, the video will be automatically paused and you may come back to resume your progress at any time.
Tap on the Home button on the top left corner of the screen and then head to the Explore tab. I will try to copy the link of SpyGuy96 project, The World's Hardest Game. Notice this paperclip logo on the project card? That is the project's URL button. And when you tap on it, it will automatically copy the URL of the project to your clipboard. When you're done, we will go back to the square and paste the URL inside the text field of the blue Open Projects block. Tap on the empty text field and select Paste. Let's try this out. Go ahead and press on the play button again. Now, if you tap on the green sticky note, Hopscotch will open up the project World's Hardest Game. The Open Project block allows you to link to any projects in Hopscotch so you can use it in many ways. For example, you can collaborate with your friends on a multi-level game and link to each other's level, or make a personal website of your favorite Hopscotch projects. Once you're inside the linked project, if you tap on the button with three dots on the top left corner, you can go visit the project's project card and give it a like if you want. Now, let's go back and fill up our bulletin board. If you tap on the Home button on the top left, it will give you the option to go to Previous Project. Tap on that, and then tap on the back arrow button to go back to Stage again. Step 3. Duplicate sticky notes. Now that we're back to the stage, an easy way to duplicate sticky notes is to copy and paste objects in the bird's eye view of the co-editor. The bird's eye view allows you to view all the objects in your game and their code at once. Tap on the icon that looks like an eye with a bunch of lines on the top right corner of the co-editor. Press your finger on the object that says square until the copy option shows up. Tap on copy and then tap on the empty space below and select paste. This will create a new square object and copy over all the code inside. Next, press the disclosure arrow at the left side of this blue container to expand the code. Make sure that you replace the URL link inside the Open Projects block for each sticky note. If you forgot how to do that, you can go back in the video and watch how to copy URL links again. To finish up our sticky notes, we will add a title to each sticky note. Open the Objects menu again and scroll all the way to the left to add a text object, and insert World Hard Disk Game for the first sticky note. Again, you can use your fingers to pinch the text to make it fit inside the sticky notes. I am also going to add a pin on top of each note using the pin emoji. Then, repeat these two steps for all of your notes, and you're done! Step 4. Creating a background. Now it's time to make the background of the bulletin board. Open the Objects menu by tapping on the gray and white plus button at the bottom half of the screen. Scroll right to the Shape section and add a circle. Let's change the name of this object to Background by tapping on its current name and typing Background. Then, press the green check. Tap Add Code and add a dotted background custom rule. This custom rule will make a solid color background using the Draw a Trail block to draw a big trail with its width set to 4000 to cover the whole screen. Then, it mimics the texture of a corkboard by adding some dotted patterns to our background. This will generate 1,000 light brown dots by creating clones at random positions on the screen and draw dots wherever the clones are made. Let's check out how it looks by pressing the play button on the top right corner of the screen. Great, now we have a board. Step 5, making a frame. Next, we will make a frame for our bulletin board. Press back to go back to the stage. Open the Objects menu again and add a text object. We'll leave the content blank so that it's invisible on the screen. Then, change the name of this object to Frame. Let's choose the Draw Frames custom rule. It will set the object to coordinate 0, 0, which is on the bottom left corner of your screen, and then move the object to the four corners one after another to draw a thick line for the frame. This custom rule repeats twice so that we have two colors of frames that add depth to our bulletin board. If you're interested to learn more about how this works, pause the video and tap on the disclosure arrow to view the code line by line. Let's check out our final product now. Congratulations on making your bulletin board! Now you can publish it to the community to share your favorite projects with your followers. Happy hopscotching!